Now, a friend, an intelligent, lapsed Jew, who incidentally observes the Sabbath for reasons of cultural solidarity, describes himself as a tooth fairy agnostic. He won't call himself an atheist because it's in principle impossible to prove a negative, but agnostic on its own might suggest that God's existence was therefore on equal terms of likelihood as his non-existence. So my friend is strictly agnostic about the tooth fairy, but it isn't very likely, is it? Like God. Hence the phrase tooth fairy agnostic. Bertrand Russell made the same point using a hypothetical teapot in orbit about Mars. You strictly have to be agnostic about whether there is a teapot in orbit about Mars, but that doesn't mean you treat the likelihood of its existence as on all fours with its non-existence. The list of things which we strictly have to be agnostic about doesn't stop at tooth fairies and teapots, it's infinite. If you want to believe one particular one of them, unicorns or tooth fairies or teapots or Yahweh, the onus is on you to say why. The onus is not on the rest of us to say why not. We who are atheists are also afairyists and ateapotists.